I keep hearing a sound like a dragon flying overhead, and it's really starting to bother me because I never see the dragon. Course, I'm sure part of the reason why I can't see the dragon is because I got this big tree mod in. So all the trees are freaking giant and block the sky. Oh, look, it's a fox. And that's our destination, right there. You get to come in here, fight a bunch of wizards, and recover Azura's star. I can't remember if there were any guards posted outside. I don't think there were. Right, here we go. Slow-mo kill cam with a freaking ice spear stuck through my shoulders. Yeah. Oh wait, that's just the storage area. Gotta go through this way. Let's be fun. Rage spell. Apparently, she brought the wolf back to life. That was easy enough. Do detect life. Nothing. Nope. I should have gotten detect dead. Incinerate. Detect undead. Memo to self. Grab that spell. Put it in my little spell book. All these necromancers. Anything interesting here? There's a necromancer cloak. Bunch of potions. Oh, hello. Thanks for the recharge on my Magicka. Always so helpful. Ooh, are those fire salts? Please tell me those are fire salts. Good. I need those later. Ooh, greater soul gem. Anything interesting in the chest? There's a diamond in the chest. Meh, nothing interesting in there. Soul gem fragments. All kinds of soul gem fragments. I always like it when the skeleton gets the slow-mo kill cam. Because the fire spells just always completely blow them apart. It's awesome. Hi. What the? The skeletons were supposed to be dispelled since I killed the guy that summoned them. But I guess those particular skeletons didn't follow those rules. And here's Azura's star. Now, at this point, we have two paths we can take. We can take the star back to the guy we talked to, Nelikar, and try to get him to fix it, and he'll turn it into the Black Star, which is essentially the same as Azura's Star, only it works as a Black Soul Gem works, which means you can trap human souls in it. Even though it says that the text on it, I believe, says it can only trap human souls in it, it actually traps normal souls in it as well. As human souls. Whereas if you take it to Azura, like I'm going to do, it's just a regular soul gem. It acts just like a regular reusable soul gem. You cannot trap human souls, only animal souls.
Beings who are to be guided from the darkness into the light, and from the light, Azura.
So, if you're metagaming pretty hard, there's no real reason to choose Azura's Star over the Black Star. But me personally, I like to do just Azura's Star instead of the Black Star. Just because.
Mother of Roses, Goddess of Dusk and Dawn, your chosen champion has returned your star. She wishes to speak to you herself. Please, place your hands on the altar, and you will hear her voice.
Greetings, mortal. You have followed my guidance through the veils of twilight, and rescued my star from Malin Varan. But his soul still resides within, protected by his enchantments. Until he is purged, my artifact is useless to you. Eventually, the star will fade back into my realm in oblivion, but I doubt you have the 100 or so years it would take to wait. No, only one option remains. I will send you inside the star. You will banish Malin's soul there. Tell me when you are ready, mortal. Have faith, mortal. I will be watching over you.
Ah, My disciples have sent me a fresh soul. Good. I was getting hungry. Why? There's something different about you.
And who are you to challenge me? I have conquered mortality itself. I've spat in the eyes of the Daedric Lords. This is my realm now. I've sacrificed too much to let you take it from me.
So now we get to fight this dude.
The star is free to purify itself. Don't worry, mortal. I will return you before you are cleansed.
Sometimes there will be more than just one Dremora. Oh. There was more than one Dremora.
My star has been restored, and Malin's soul has been consigned to oblivion. You have done well, mortal. As was destined, you are free to use my star as you see fit. Farewell, mortal. Know that Azura will be guarding over the threads of your fate in the twilight.
Wait, the Black Star? Oh, right, the... I was there, I was a little confused.
While you were in the star, Azura gave me a vision. Her last, she said. I have never been without Azura's foresight since escaping Morrowind. I don't know what to do. If you need me, I'd be honored to accompany you, Guardian of the Star. It would give me a purpose. Twilight, watch over you, Guardian.
So she becomes a follower once you're done. Assuming you got Azura's Star instead of the Black Star. If you didn't, I'm pretty sure she becomes hostile to you. So, it's just something to consider. And now, let's see. I can do Meridia's quest. I can do Mehrunes Dagon's quest. I actually got the pamphlet for that earlier. But, I think instead I'm going to do something a bit more fun, and a bit more interesting.
Then it's true, what everyone is saying, that Aventus Aretino is doing the Black Sacrament, trying to summon the Dark Brotherhood?
Oh, Grimbar, always with the nonsense. No, no, of course not. Those are just tales.
Fine, then I'll invite him out to play. He lives right there. I'm going to knock on his door.
No, child. Wait! That boy, that house, they are cursed.
Ha! Then I'm right. I knew it. He's trying to have somebody killed.
All right. I won't deny it, child. What you heard is true. But Aventus Aretino walks a dark path. His actions can lead only to ruin. Now, enough. We will speak no more of this. I am the only friend you need.
So yeah, we're going to join the Dark Brotherhood. Oh, she doesn't become hostile, she just won't speak to you. Okay, I wasn't sure, because I've actually never done the Black Star version of that quest. I just assumed she would become hostile since,
sweet mother, send your child unto me, for the sins of the unworthy must be baptized in blood and fear. Sweet mother...
You've come at last! I knew you would! It worked! I knew you'd come! I just knew it! I did the Black Sacrament over and over with the body and the things, and then you...